O come, Emmanuel. Come and rescue us. It's an old song, and I was curious just how old it was. So this morning I looked it up, and it's at least 11 centuries old. For at least 1,100 years, Christians have been singing this song. So it's really old. Originally in Latin, of course, and now in English. And it's an old song, but it tells an even older story. The people of the world lived in darkness, and they have seen a great light. We sing this song today because we still need it. We need that light, and so we cry out, Lord Jesus, come and rescue us. If you have a student at Badger High School or the middle school, you know that Thanksgiving break started an hour early this year because of a threat written on a bathroom wall. And after the shootings in Pittsburgh, and Madison, and even Delavan, you can understand the extra measure of caution and concern. And if that's not enough for kids to worry about, vaping is rampant at the middle school as well as the high school. And of course, the opioid epidemic and other forms of substance abuse remain some of the significant concerns in our community. And the response that we received to our series on mental health has been tremendous. It was a powerful few weeks where a lot of healing took place. And during that same time period, there were people who were receiving bad news. We had three of our members diagnosed with cancer in the space of 1 week. We cry out, come, Lord Jesus, we need the light of your presence. And the light of Christ is shining. 2 weeks ago, our youth group led worship, and they presented a message about Habakkuk, or Habakkuki. And after that service, a family who was struggling with some tough news they got emailed to tell us that what they had heard that morning was that God is in that dark. God is in the dark. And it was a powerful message for them to receive at that time. And we can continue to watch for God in hopeful expectation. Jesus is the light we look for in this season, and we know we will see it. This morning we worship, we pray. Our music is prayer. Hearing the readings from God's word, that is prayer. God speaks to us. Sharing the peace of God with family and friends is prayer, because through one another we share and experience God's love. In all these things, the light of Jesus ignites within us. Jesus is the light that we long for and need. O come, Emmanuel. Jesus is here. The light shines in these short days and long nights. The light shines on this journey through life. And as we finish this morning, we look just a little further down the road, because the culmination of our Advent journey is coming soon. The last piece that we'll share looks forward to the true glory and joy of Christmas. And this piece also dares to look even further down the road than that. It looks toward the day when all of us will be truly united in peace, when we will all walk in the light of God. We will all truly love one another as Jesus loves all of us. That is the day when the world will sing, "Glory to God in the highest."
So yes, thank you to all our musicians, our instruments, our singers, our ringers. I told you guys I wanted you to come up here. So we're clapping for your ghosts, I guess, over here. But yes, an awesome day. And Adam Smith, our conductor, is literally taking conducting class this semester at school, right? And does this count at all toward your grade? It's too bad. This is the first time Adam's ever conducted anything like this. So thank you, Adam, for a job well done.